Hello students, so today we are going to start with our standard 6 subject science lesson number 2, the living world, with the second half revision of our lesson. So the first topic which we were continuing is characteristics of living thing. So another characteristic is reproduction. Living things produce other living things like themselves. Some animals give birth to their young ones where some lay eggs. Their young ones hatch out of the eggs. New plants are produced from the seeds, stems or leaves of plants. The process by which a living thing generates a new living thing like itself is called reproduction or procreation. Reproduction is a characteristic of living things. Reproduction. It is a next stage. At a certain stage of life, living things become capable of reproduction. Later on in life, reproduction stage, their organs become weak and still later, their life comes to an end. In other words, living things die. The lifespan of different animals and plants are different. For example, the lifespan of the dog is about 12 to 18 years, while the ostrich lives for 50 years. You may have wondered what exactly the living things are, how they come into being and so on. So for that, we have another explanation, but before there is, do you know that the lifespan of the giant turtle found on the Galapagos Island in South America is about 170 year old. On the other hand, the lifespan of the mayfly ranges from 1 hour to 24 hours. So students, you may have seen the small compartments of the honeycomb. These compartments are joined together to form a honeycomb. A valve has bricks to construct a wall. We firmly join the bricks together. This leads to a cellular structure. Students, living things are made up of small units like honeycombs, which are called as cells. All the actions and process in the body of every living thing is brought about with the help of these microscopic cells. Some living things are made up of single cell. These are called as unicellular organisms like amoeba, paramecium. These cannot be seen easily only with the help of a microscope. On the other hand, the living things that are made of many cells are called as multicellular organism. The amoeba and other microorganisms are unicellular, correct? While man, cow, mouse, cockroach, elephant, banyan tree, the onion plant, etc. Everything is a multicellular organism. All the characteristics of living things are seen in every cell of living thing, whether it is unicellular or multicellular. Cellular structure is the main characteristic of the living thing, even though the number of cells may vary in different living things. Okay? So now, other topic is institutes at works. So student, the institute that work for the survey and conservation of the various plants and animals in different parts of India are the Botanical Survey of India, which was held in 1890, and the Zoological Survey of India 1916 respectively. In case you find an unfamiliar plant or animal in your surrounding, you can communicate with these institute to obtain more information. Students, Botanical Survey is done for plants, whereas Zoological Survey is done for animals. Okay? Moving next is useful living things. Plants are used for household as well as industrial purposes. For example, fenugreek, that is methi, potato, okra, that is bhindi, apple, banana are used as food, while vasaka, which is also called as edulsa, hirada, behada, asparagus are used as medicines. Animals are also useful to us. Dogs, cats, cows, buffaloes are kept for domestic uses. Fish, sheep, fowl are used as food. While animals like horses, oxen, camel prove useful in various occupations. Now, harmful living things. Some animals and plants around us are harmful to man. For example, mosquito and flies spread disease. Cockroach, mice, rats destroy our food. Lice, ticks also spread disease. The bites of some poisonous lizards, spiders, snake and scorpions can even cause death. If wild elephants enter human settlements, they cause a lot of destruction. Some plants too can be harmful on, for example, the dodder, peritoneum and other weeds. Pods of the nettle, colocasia leaves cause itching. Plants like oleander, lantana have strong odors. The datura plant is poisonous. Uncontrolled growth of fungi and algae in water pollutes drinking water and may cause the spread of disease. Moving ahead, we have wild animals. Even wild animals that hunt other animals for food are also called as predators. For example, tigers, lions, wolves, leopards. Sometimes due to deforestation, such animals enter human settlements in search of food and may kill domestic animals or people. So here we finish with the revision part of our lesson. I hope you all understood it well. We'll meet in next session with our next lesson. Till then, thank you.